I'm Venkatesham. I'm going to discuss about pH of mixture of acids and bases in this video. We have four types of titrations are there. Our third titration is that is a strong acid versus this is a strong acid versus there is an weak base. Strong acid versus this is in a weak base. It has strong acid versus that is in a weak base. Strong acid versus weak base, my yo. And you can consider the X milli equivalents of strong acid. Consider that X is a milli equivalents of strong acid and Y is a milli equivalents of strong weak base. Right. So again here there is another three situations will be raised. My X is equals to Y, milli equivalents of strong acid equals to milli equivalents of weak base, then it forms a salt. The salt is a which is a definitely it will undergo the hydrolysis because it is a salt formed from the strong acid and weak base, and that hydrolysis takes place. In this hydrolysis here there is a salt concentration is equals to, so which is you take that either a milli equivalents of X or a milli equivalents of a strong acid or milli equivalents of a weak base divided by its total volume. What total volume is here? That is the sum of the volume of strong acid and a weak base. Now you can use the formula here. That is now pH is equals to this is a 7 minus here it is in a 1 by 2 of this is a pKb. This is a log C, or I can write this is a log concentration, my salt concentration. So this is a formula that is helpful to find out its pH. And the second one is here I can take this is a X greater than the Y. X is greater than Y is nothing but milli equivalents of strong acid is more than the milli equivalents of a weak base. Then the resulting solution is acidic in nature. And you can find your H plus ion concentration is equals to that is equals to normality, and you can take that is an X minus Y divided by its total volume of the strong acid and a weak base. From this I can able to find your pH is equals to that is a minus log of its H plus ion concentration. So this is a simple one. And third one is if there is a X is less than the Y. X is less than the Y means so Y is dominating and a weak base is left over, or weak base is unused in the titration. Whenever the weak base is unused, then definitely it forms the basic buffer. This basic buffer pH can be calculated by using its Anderson equation. So in that Anderson equation and your salt concentration and a base concentration should be required. Your salt concentration should be equals to the it's a strong acid milli equivalents that is in X. Why? Because it is going to be completely consumed and it is a limiting reagent. So that I can write here X divided by its total volume. Okay, for salt concentration or base concentration I can write this is in Y minus X. Here Y minus X divided by this is a total volume. So why? Because milli equivalents of base is a dominating, so that Y minus X divided by it's a total volume. You got here salt concentration and base concentration. Use the Anderson equation. pH is equals to that is enough. This is a basic buffer. Now you can write directly pOH ma. So pOH is equals to this is a pKb plus your log salt concentration divided by here it is a base concentration. So this is a formula to find out its a pOH, and from that you can find its a pH is equals to then it's a 14 minus its a pOH. Okay, so this is a formula to find out its a pH. This is for the strong acid and versus its a weak base. And next one is a fourth one, fourth type of titration is that is an weak acid. Here fourth one is that is a weak acid versus this is a weak base. So consider x milli equivalents of weak acid and y is the milli equivalents of weak base. If there is an three situations will be raised here, and if x equals to y means that is an milli equivalents of weak acid is equals to milli equivalents of weak base. There is a salt is going to be formed, this salt and it is definitely will undergo the hydrolysis. In this hydrolysis, it is a salt formed from the weak acid versus weak base, so that it will undergo the hydrolysis. To find out its pH, you will use the formula here, that is in pH is equals to, so this is a 7 plus 1 by 2, 7 plus 1 by 2 here pKa minus here it is a pKb is a formula to find out the it's a pH of it's a weak acid versus weak base. Whenever there is a milli equivalence of weak acid equals to milli equivalence of weak base, then it is a this is a formula to find out. And the next one is if milli equivalence of weak acid is more than the milli equivalence of weak base, so then the resulting solution is acidic in nature. That means whatever the solution is formed now, that resulting solution is acidic in nature. That acidic solution pH can be calculated by using x greater than the y. X greater than the y means milli equivalence of acid is greater than the milli equivalence of base. Resulting solution is acidic in nature. So that acidic solution is going to be formed here. That acidic solution is acidic buffer is going to be formed. Second case is x is greater than the y, milli equivalence of weak acid is greater than the milli equivalence of weak base, then it forms a acidic buffer. So this acidic buffer and here salt concentration should be equals to the for that acidic buffer and salt concentration should be which will be equals to the y because y is going to be completely consumed, weak base is completely consumed and it is a limiting reagent, so that I can write y divided by its total volume. Okay, and here acid concentration is equals to, so that I can write down this is simply x minus y divided by its total volume. So by using this one we'll find out it's by using the Anderson equation, concentration of salt and acid, and I use the Anderson equation, that is a pH is equals to this is a pKa plus this is a log salt concentration and divided by here it is a acid concentration. Use this formula to find out its pH. So salt concentration and acid concentration you will get by using that milli equivalents of acid and it's a salt. And the next one is third case is if there is a milli equivalence of weak acid is less than the milli equivalence of base, then it forms this is a basic buffer. Here a basic buffer is going to be formed. So that basic buffer definitely it requires again your salt concentration. Salt concentration is that is acid is completely consumed. No, so that acid is a weak acid is a limiting reagent divided by its total volume. Okay. And here salt that is a base concentration is equals to, so this is a y minus x divided by its total volume, right? So we can write here salt concentration as well as a base concentration, and by using that Anderson equation we can find its pH is equals to, here it is a pKb, this is a basic buffer, no, so that you can write POH pKb plus this is a log salt concentration divided by it is a base concentration. So this is a formula, and we can find from this pH is equals to this is a 14 minus here it is a POH. So this is a formula that can be used to find out its pH.